So I shared the instance in the WhatsApp group. Okay, morning. Let me pause recording, guys. Resume our thing. So yesterday we covered enterprise name, one of the architecture concept enterprise name we covered. And we started the ledger. In the ledger, we completed accounting calendar and currency. Now we are going to do COA. COA is chart of account structure. Means whenever any transactions if you want to record into the Oracle Cloud, there we require the which accounts it will hit. Which accounts it will hit. For example, if you are doing any material transactions, for example, if you are adding the stock, which chart of account it will hit. When you are doing account payable, which chart of account will hit. When you are creating PRs, which account will hit. So all these combinations we are going to define in the chart of account structure. So the chart of account structure, if you wanted to configure it, there are four setups. There are four setups. So what and all setups which we need to configure for this COA is, let me close this. Let me open the application. So that is what my sincere suggestion is. Whenever the recording session is over, if we are doing the practice, first you prepare the highlights, prepare the notes. Then you go to instance and try to practice it. If you follow these two to three steps, then the even for the new guy, new members like Suresh, because Suresh, for you, it is completely new, right? So for you, it will be very easy. As soon as if you are doing day-to-day daily practice, it will be easy. Otherwise, only one day, one fine day, if you open the things, it will be again the new concepts only. Okay. So do the practice. So before practicing, first understand the video and then prepare your notes and go to the instance and do the practice. So follow these three steps consistently, then you know things will be in your control. So now, what and all setups are required to configure the chart of account structure? So for that, go to setup and maintenance. Go to financial reporting structure. So these are the things. Manage chart of account structure, chart of account structure instance, value sets, and value sets values. All these four tasks are helpful to create your COA. Okay. So what is value set is, suppose, so COA is basically the segment combination. Segment combinations. So what is a segment combination means? So first segment should be company. Just giving example. Okay. Next one is cost center. Next one is natural account. Next segment is intercompany. Next segment is future enabled. Okay. So what is companies? For example, let's say you have what you called, there are companies like, you know, Tata Steel is one company. Tata Motor is one company. Tata Motors, let us take. Okay. So the company segment will decide the specific transaction is happening for which company. So if I here I can give the notations like Tata Steel is 100, Tata Motors is 200, maybe Tata IT is 300. So like that, based on this company segments, the system will decide this particular transaction will be recording to which company. So that is called company segment. And cost centers, it is again internal of the company. Maybe invent AP side cost center. There are multiple cost centers you have. So you can decide, how many cost centers you want for each company. So it will be combinations, like for example, if it is 100, let's say this is one of the cost center. I am giving notations here 200. Okay. So if a natural account is for expense, one combination. Intercompany we are not using. So let's say like this. See, this particular combination, if it is changed, means cost center will change. So cost centers will increment. I'll give the cost centers the examples. So natural account. So from these combinations, we'll understand the transaction, the specific, what you called, the transactions is happening under the Tata Steel. Because the company, as per our example, the company segment is 100. Okay. So like this is the combination of the various values we are going to configure in the COE. So these values we are not entering during our transactions. So this has to be set up in the system so that when you are doing the transactions, the users can select it from the drop downs. Okay. Now, for that, first, how many value sets you want means how many segments you require in your chart of account. So, based on how many segments, you can decide that many value sets you have to create in the value set, manage chart of account value sets. Correct. So, click on this. So click on plus. So my value set, first value set is GRY. So I'm using prefix I told right yesterday. GRY company. So module, what is the module here? General ledger. The module is general ledger. And validation type. See here, there are multiple. We have format only. Format only means then the combination values we no need to enter into the setup. These combinations can be entered during the transactions. So when you choose the format, then these values we no need to do the setups in the master data. I mean, to the setup is not required to enter these values. So these values, when you are doing the transactions, directly the user can enter. That is called as format. Independent. Independent means this value set is whether it is independently working or it is depends upon some other value set. So that is called as independent. Dependent means value set is depend upon any another value set. And subset table is the table we have subset we are not using. So table is the values. For example, I am creating the value set GRY company. So for this, the value set values, if you want to pull from specific table of Oracle, then we are going to use this table format. We need to give select star from what is the class, what is the value, all kind of stuff. Okay. Now we are going to use the independent. Some of the areas we are going to use format, dependent, tables. Right? Now independent value data type, whether it is character, number, date type. So if you use the character, it will allow format. Means it is a combination of character plus numeric. So I'm using value subtype is test. So maximum length. So what is the length we want to use? I want to use 5 characters. Okay. And here uppercase only if you enable, even if you pass the test, automatically system will convert into uppercase letters. The zero fill means, suppose for example, I given the maximum length is 5. Suppose we entered only three characters, 100. So if you click on the 0 field, rest of the two fields, automatically system will append two zeros automatically. That is called as 0 field. Okay. If it is required, you can enable. Otherwise, it is optional. The minimum value also, if it is required, you can enable it. You can pass it. Otherwise, not required. Okay, so like that, you create your value sets. So I'm creating some more value sets. So first is the company. Minimum, if you want to create the COA, what and all value sets required is at least three value sets are mandatory. Company, cost center, and natural accounts. Company, cost center, natural accounts. Okay, if these three are not there, then the system won't allow to define your COA as well as in the transactions also, it will be restricted. Okay, now save and close. Now I'll create another one. So JRY cost center. So same general ledger. Here again independent, here character, value subtype text, here file, save and close. Now, JRY natural account. Module. General ledger validation type. If it is format, did you observe here this manage after saving manage values won't come? So let me give this attribute value. If it is saved, okay, let me enter this. See, if it is saved, the manage values won't come. Means the format, if you select the format, then the values we cannot enter in the master data, we can enter directly into the transactions. Okay, now one more thing, once you click on save, we don't have any option to delete, guys. So we have to be very careful while doing the things. So now to show the example I given, let it be okay. Okay, so I'll keep format only for this natural account. No, I want to create one more. JRY natural CCU account. General ledger for, sorry, independent. If it is dependent, system will ask what is the independent value. This I am showing the examples of different things. So text file, save, the manage value scheme. Okay. Now one more is JRY intercompany. What is intercompany? Intercompany is, let's say in your ledger there are two BUs. Okay, BU1 India and Bangalore and Hyderabad. Okay, so these two are belongs to same ledger. Okay, when you do the transactions between these two, for example, let's say the Bangalore doesn't have the stock. So he want to, instead of purchasing the things from the outside, he can send a request to the Hyderabad saying that I need this particular stock. So there is that some transactions will happen between Bangalore to Hyderabad. That we call it as an intercompany. intercompany. So within the ledger, whenever any transactions will happen across the BUs, that we call it as a intercompany transactions. Independent character section. Hit by. So there are multiple. We have translated test. This is for like, you know, some countries, they cannot understand English, right? They can use the different language. So we need to give the translation test something. So there is another language kind of things we have to give. But whenever if we are configuring this particular implementation for different countries, so we have a lot of other setups also subsequently apart from whatever setup we are doing. So when it is other than English, we need to use the translated text. So this is intercompany, and I'll use one future segment. Future segment. Again, independent character means in future. Maybe I wanted to bring one more segment that time. I can use this buffered segment. So that is what I'm creating. One future segment. So that's all here. Now my value sets has been done. Any questions here? So to push, I mean to move to the structure instance, value sets creation is mandatory.
Okay, I have one question over here. This thing, what you're showing up, is it mandate for every SCM consultant to have knowledge on this, or it's like for example, if I'm looking only for management?
Yeah, it is finance. Actually, this configuration has to do by the financial consultant. Okay, just for knowledge of SCM, I'm showing the setup.
Understood.
But actually speaking, this particular setup we won't do, SCM won't do. Right? Now I'm going to the chart of account structure. So chart of account structure is the key flex field. So there are three flex fields we have in the Oracle. So what and all the flex fields to support is DFF, descriptive flex field, and EFF, extensive flex field, and KFF is key flex field. So DFF, EFF will be used in the transaction screens. Transaction screens means when you wanted to bring extra fields, when you wanted to bring extra fields other than seeded fields as given by the ORCID, then they're going to use the DFF and EFF concepts. Okay. So all these two are belongs to transaction screens like PR, PO, invoice, okay, inventory, stock creation, all kind of stuff is the examples of transaction screens. Whereas KFFs will be used in the configurations. So this is basically helpful to create your TOA. And we have some another one like a locator structure for the inventory. Okay. So these areas, as per SCM point of view, SCM and financial, So as per SCM and financial, this KFF concept will be used in the COA and locator. So locator also one of the architecture, Oracle Cloud structure. Right. Now this is the KFF we are using. Now click on search here and go to manage structure. Go to manage structure. click on plus to provide your structure name. So I'm going to always use the JRY. You can give any name, there is no restriction, but these names, so the user will provide this, you these particular names if you want, you have to use kind of stuff. Now delimiter is to differentiate, to separate your segments, separate your segments, whatever segments which are present in the COA, to separate that we are using the delimiter. So once you give this name, code and delimiter, you can't save, and then segments will be enabled. So click on plus. Now you have to give the segment code. So here the segments will be mapped with your value set. That is what we define the value sets earlier. Okay. Now save JRY company. So API names will be used for integration. Means whenever your cloud application will be integrated with third-party applications, so that time this API names will be helpful. Okay. So this will be default automatically based on our segment code. So we don't need to enter manually here. It will come automatically once you fill the segment code here. Correct. Now copy that name, description, sequence number. This is one. So prompt, subprompt, all these things will be, some of the help things will be helpful for reports as well. Reports. So display width is 5. And what is the column which has been stored into the database of this particular here company segment? So I want to store into segment 1. And we need to map the value set code here. The value set code is JRY company. So JRY. Now this company we need to map here. So the company is the primary balancing segment. The company, what we need to do, what we need to map, we need to map with the primary balancing segment. So this concept is financial concept. I am also not sure what is this particular segment labels will be helpful in the financial side. So if it is company, blindly the fundamental is we need to map with the primary balancing segment. Now save it. Save and close. Now create rest of the things. So JRY cost center. Again. Name. This is second segment. Display width 5. Range type is not required. The segment 2. Here this is cost center. Sometimes it won't come, so we need to select from drop down. Cost center. So here this is cost center segment. Save it, save and close. Now JRY. What is that? Natural account. Natural account. Sequence 3, prompt, dot prompt. This is again 5. Store into the segment 3. Here it is JRY. JRY. It is natural account. So you should not select the format. You should select the independent. And here we need to map to natural account segment. Next one is intercompany. Intercompany. Sequence, this is core. Column is segment 4. This is chair wise. Intercompany. So here you need to map to intercompany segment. Now last one, future. Future enable. Chair wise future. Enable. So this is 5. Describe it by column name segment 5. This is JRY feature. JRY feature. Okay, so this one we can apply to feature segment. Save, save and close. So like that, how many segments you want, that many value sets you have to define, and then that many segments you have to define. Save and close. Click on done. So structure is done. Now we need to create the structure instance. We need to create the structure instance. So JRY structure INS something. So API name will come, name. Here we need to map the structure name. So JRY AFS. The system automatically pull all the segments. And after that, we need to required has to be enabled. So click on edit and you need to enable the required. So this is only one time setup. We don't need to do multiple times. So that is what, when you are doing the setups, we need to be very cautious. Because once you done that, system won't allow to modify it. System will allow to make a end date for some of the thing, but it won't allow to delete it from the database. So save it, save and close. Click on done. Now structure is done, structure instance is done. Now in order to affect this particular TOA, then we need to deploy the flex field. Deploy the flex field. So during your deployment, when you get some error, then your COA won't be available for the transactions. That's why. So we have to be like, you know, once deployment is done, so once everything is okay, it will come here green color. It will come here green color. So let us wait for deployment. So once deployment is completed, then we can go to primary ledger and then create a ledger. Okay. So let us wait for the deployment. So it will come like, finished kind of stuff, kind of, pop up. So let us wait for some time. So always remember, like, COE is only one, TOE is enough for your complete. Let's say if you have 10 companies or 15 companies, how many companies you have? So most of the time, COE is only one. COE is only one. They won't create multiple COEs because since it is a demo instance, you can find multiple COEs. But in the practical environment, in the client environment, we can find only single COA. Is happening. There is no errors, but it is taking time. So zero errors, warnings are fine. There is no issues. So we should not get any errors. Okay, so once it is completed, let us wait one more time. It will come this one. It should wait. Okay, fine. So let it complete. Now we'll see. Once it is completed, go to setup and maintenance, general ledger, refresh the page, general ledger, manage primary ledger. Yeah. See, now it will come. Deployment completely successful. And click on OK. After that, it will come like it has been deployed. If it is not coming this green color, then there will be some issue. Okay. Now click on Done. So go to Manage Primary Ledger. Now create your primary ledger. Create your ledger. The ledger is basically helpful to record the complete transactions. So why we need to record? Because over a 1 year period of time, like, every year, they wanted to know what is the status of the company. So they want to pull the P&L reports, profit and loss report, balancing sheets. So all these profit and loss balancing sheets, if you want to pull each and every transaction of the whatever happening in the business, it has to be recorded and it will hit the general ledger finally. So using that general ledger, the basic purpose of this ledger is to helpful or to check your status of your company. I mean to say, what is the health check, like, whether it is in the profit mode or in the last mode, and the balance sheet will be helpful to get the detailed information for each and every department wise. Okay, so for that, so ledger is mandatory. Suppose we have a four companies, like four ledgers using same COA. If it is five companies, five ledgers using same COA. So like that, you have to do it. Now JRY, primary ledger. So now chart of account is ours, JRY. So here, always we are mapping structure instance, not a structure. Okay. Now, accounting calendar, GRY. GRY. Currency is USD. Accounting methods is like, you know, this is, we don't have any option to create our own account methods. So we need to use the existing, like a seeded accounting methods. So seeded accounting methods are either, if it is China, they're going to use the, for China is this one. Otherwise, we can use the standard accrual method. Standard accrual method. So with this, the primary ledger creation is completed. So let me put it the ledger name here. Okay. Now, after creation of the ledger, then we need to do, in the ledger itself, there is some more tasks. So what is the task is? One second. So go to organization structure again. Sorry. Go back to financials. General ledger. So next is specify ledger options. So specify ledger options. So here you have to select your ledger. Because we created, right? So we need to, this status has to come from, we need to enable the ledger. So that is the specify ledger option. So GRY. So select it, save and close. So the status will come. Once you fulfill this, it will come like a green color. Okay. So here, you need to enter retain account and what is the language. So these two are important. Means which language this particular ledger will be created. It is US language. If it is German, whatever. So American English is US. And what is a retain account is? So the basic definition of this retain account is, so let's say, you started a business to 2023. Okay. So started like with some 5 members. Now you got some 100 million profit. So out of 100 million profit, some 10 million profit you want to carry to the 2024. So that particular 10 million profit, where they're going to assign in the system is in the retain earning accounts. So this particular account, they're going to map this particular 10 million profit. So that is the usage of your retain earning accounts. Now I'll add one earning account. So why I'm not getting the values here? Because I have not created any values for the value sets, whatever I have given. So I don't have any option to choose my own value sets, because if I open the drop down, nothing is showing. It means that there is no value sets has been defined yet. So first we need to finish that. So go to setup and maintenance. Organization structure. So let me refresh. Go to financials, reporting structure. Here, this one we are not finished. Chart of account, value sets. Now, you have to pull your value sets. Means whatever value sets you created. So search now. The company. So click on manage values. So provide the companies, company values. What is the company values you want to give? So 1,000, 3, 4, 10,000. So till 5 characters I can give. If I give a 6 character, system will give error while saving. See, the value of this is too long, so we define only maximum 5 characters. Now this is just something like gry company 101 something. Next, so next is copy that. Here I'll give one. This is my company to something 02. Click on plus. Copy that. So this is company 3. Like that, how many companies you have, that many company value segments or values you can define here. Save it. So enough for me. Save and close. Now cost centers. Select that, manage values. So now I'm going to use that 2 series. The 2 5, how many we have? 2 5. So this is financial cost center something. Finance cost center. So 01. This is procurement cost center. ERC cost center. Similarly, one more. 2 is inventory cost center something. Save it. Save and close. Now, now natural account. Okay, intercompany future accounts I'll give only 00, because this one I am going to use later. And now 4 5 future enable whatever. Now natural account for this one, because this is format only, it won't allow to enter values. So here I'm going to use the 3 series, 3 4. This is asset something. Must enter the value attribute accounting. Okay, accounting type pattern asset. Okay. Now asset 01 or whatever, 01 30 01. This is also asset. Something 01 and keep. So this many, like, you know, you can create few things. Now 002 liability. So like that, you can define multiple values here. Save it. Save and close. Now I'll create intercompany. Intercompany also we don't want to use anything. So I'm going to use default one. 345 default something. So all these combination values the client will provide. So we need to enter into the system. Now values has been configured. Now you go to specify ledger options. Now open the retained account. It will show the combinations. So we need to refresh the page. Cancel. Switch to. Now go back again. Setup and maintenance. General ledger. Specify ledger options. Apply and go task. Now click on this. Okay. So first time it won't come. It we have to choose that. Cost center. Natural account something. Intercompany 00. Default is 00. Click on OK. Okay. And language is American English, US. What happened? US American English. So rest of the things, it is optional for us. We don't know what is suspense account, rounding account, currency banking, lot of financial stuff will be there here. So this is enough. Just written account language. And first open period is January. And number of future enterable periods. It should be one. Either one or two, whichever you want, you can give. Save it. Save and close. Now, if you open the specify ledger options, not here. Go to ledger now, manage primary ledger. If I choose my ledger, it will show here green color. So it is still, it is running. Now we need to enter some more things. So ledger, specify ledger options has been completed. Next task is we need to primary ledger over, specify ledger options is over, and then we need to define the balancing segments. So for that, all tasks. Assign balancing segment to ledger. Okay. It is nothing but whatever segment values we created, right? So we need to map here. So click on that. We need to refresh the page. Financials. Reporting structure. Alt pass. Not here. General ledger. Here. All tasks assign balancing segments values to the ledger. So scope is my ledger only. So we need to enter the company segments here. 100 company one. So here this is Tata Steel, Tata Motors, and Tata IT like that. Okay. Now this is the next setup. After that, save it, save and close. Now next one is, we need to map the ledger with the legal entity. We need to map the ledger with the legal entity. So for that, to go to legal structure, call task. Here we have one task that is not here. Associate balancing segments. No, this one. Go to financial report instruction only. All tasks. Yeah. Oh, sorry. General ledger. All tasks. Here we have a option. Where is the... Yeah, assign legal entities. Assign legal entities. So we are assigning my ledger with my legal entity. Plus legal entity is zero. Yesterday we created, right? And company values we need to create in the legal entity, not in the ledger. Ledger already created, right? Now we need to define the company values. Assign legal entities is over. Assign balancing segment to the legal entities. Okay, so JRY legal entity came. Okay, company values you need to define whatever you define earlier. Okay, company values are not coming up. Value set company. Okay, so this has to come from there. Okay, I'll check this one. I don't think so it is required here. Okay, let me check that. Let me check later. Now, finally, see what and all I did. Ledger I created and specify ledger options I created and map the ledger with the legal entity and then specify balancing segments to the ledger. And final setup is review and submit the accounting configuration. Review and submit the accounting configuration. So click on this. The scope is JRY. Now we just submit this particular program. So once it is submitted, then your ledger will be in the active status in the Oracle Cloud. Correct? Now submit. Now submit. The creation, some one of the program will run. So once it has been completed, so then you can verify that particular program, the tools. So go to tools. Here schedule process will be there, one program, one icon. So I don't have that icon. I don't know why it is not there. Let me check here. This is also one navigator, same thing. Here. No, schedule program is not there. I given all the roles, but somehow it is not showing. Maybe that is some issue with the application. So in order to see that schedule program, tomorrow I'll show. So I'm going to log in with another user like SCM underscore MPL. So with the help of that, I'll show the schedule program. Okay. Now, once after completion of that last step, once you go back and open the primary ledger, now it should come. So it is not coming. So this particular thing has to come like a green color. Okay, it is not coming. Maybe balancing segment values. Sign out and sign in one. So once that program has been completed, then this particular thing will show. Setup and maintenance, open that. Go to ledger. Manage primary ledger. JRY. Yeah, it is. In process it is doing. Okay, so there is something it is missing too. All tasks. I think balancing segments you need to define. Assign balancing segment values. I don't think so. Here it is required. Just okay, fine. Just delete it. Let us see. First, we need to map this balancing segments to the legal entity, not ledger. So let us see that. We went close. Now go back and assign balancing segments to the legal entities. Okay. Select that. Primary ledger is fine. Okay. Apply and go task. Manage secondary ledgers for this. No, this one. Assign balance segments to legal entities. Select the primary ledger only here. Apply and go task. Not this one. There is one task here. We go to legal structures. Balancing segments, manage associate balances. Okay, open that. Legal entity. Select and add. So my legal entity is JRY. Select that. Save and close. What it is happening? I missed something here. Financials. Here only will be there. We did several times. Assign balancing segment legal entities. Same thing. It is asking to create the lecture. Okay, I'll check that I am missing something here, because this is we are not touching frequently. That is what we need to forget the things. Here only it should come. Okay. Now let me try that. Not coming. Company values should come here. Okay, I'll check, guys. I'll check and I'll let you know tomorrow. Okay, so this is the primary ledger setup. Okay, and once that segments has been mapped, then if you go back to your ledger, here. So yeah, this will come like status. See, this is why it was not come earlier, is because the program was running. Okay, but status is now it is okay, but we need to map the balancing segments. So that particular thing I'll show tomorrow how to do that. Okay, because I'm pretty sure, like, you know, balancing segment values will be added to the legal entity or ledger. So there is confusion here. I'll clarify the confusion tomorrow. Like, where we need to map the segment values, whether it is to the ledger or legal entity. Okay. So with that, the ledger creation has been completed. So what and all we did? So we created a ledger and we specify ledger options and then assign legal entity with ledger and finally review completed transaction. So after completion of ledger creation, we need to do these things. Then only your ledger will be in the active status in the cloud application. Right? Now, tomorrow we'll see BUs, all BU inventory, sub inventories, all the stuff, all kind of stuff. Right? So any questions today? Aishwin, you have any question? Hello?
Needs a practice on this, how to create a COA ledger and the segments combination. Maybe we need to follow the procedure multiple times,
correct.
Only then we can.
So that is what daily practice, you have to do the practice. If you do every day, then you know it will take very less time. If you do after 1 week, it will take more time. So practice is always every day without fail. So prepare your note, prepare your some steps, and then do the practice. And that way it will, what you call, store in our mind permanently. Okay. So I give an instance, I give an everything. So after a few days, I'll give even old recorded sessions as well. Okay. That things I'll give subsequently to you. All right. So if you don't have any questions, we'll wind up the session. Suresh, any questions you have?
No.
Okay, are you following, Suresh?
Yeah, I am. But I'm just a bit confused that this seems to be like, the finance thing, whether this will fit into the SCM role or not, kind of thing.
No, it is not at all fit into the SCM role, but we need to know some idea.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I understand that.
Okay. Okay, guys. So tomorrow we'll get. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.